Good evening and welcome to Worship Online with Tuscaloosa United Methodist Church for a family worship night service.
We're so glad you're here!
Tonight our theme is protection from Jesus' words in John 17.
Right after worship at 7, we have some small groups to join so that we can connect. Willa Kids for children, Gravity Youth for middle and high school, and an adult group that is talking about prayer. Now join us for a time of singing God's praises.
Into marvelous light I'm running, out of darkness, out of shame. Through the cross you are the truth, you are the light. Fatherless, a stranger with no hope. Your kindness wakened me from my sleep. Now your love, it beckons deeply, a call to come and die. By grace now I will come and take this life. Take has lost its power, death has lost its sting. From the grave you've risen victoriously. Into marvelous light I'm running, out of darkness, out of shame. Through the cross you are the truth, you are the life. Stains now clean. Your breath fills up my lungs. Now I'm free. Now I'm free. My dead heart now is beating. My deepest stains now clean. Your breath fills up my lungs. Now I'm free. Now I'm free. Sin has lost
and keeping us safe. We pray for everyone who is sick in the world. Help us to grow and to serve others. Amen.
I'm so glad you could worship with us tonight at our family night worship time. My name is Heather Harding. I'm the pastor at Tuscarora United Methodist Church. And tonight we are looking at John 17. And in it is this beautiful prayer that Jesus prays for the disciples. And so we believe that Jesus is still praying that prayer for us. So when it starts out in the prayer, he is praying for God to glorify him. And you know, we use that word a lot, glory and glorify, but it really means for the transforming presence of God to be manifested, to be seen, so that people can see God through what Jesus is doing. And then it says that Jesus is praying for the disciples. He's praying for us. He's praying that they would be safe from the evil one. So it's this wonderful prayer of protection. Jesus has nurtured all of the disciples all of this time. He's walked with them. He's taught them. He's healed them. He's been friends with them. And so he doesn't want anything bad to happen to them. And he especially doesn't want them to be tempted by evil thoughts. So he prays for their protection. And then he prays that each disciple would be made holy, so that they can do this powerful work in the world. Jesus is praying for us to be made holy so that we can go out there and serve, and so that God's glory can be seen in the world. And then the last thing he prays is for us to stay united, that this group has gotten together and that Jesus has loved them and they have loved him back. And he wants them to be united with each other. You know, it's kind of like in our family when brothers and sisters fight, the parents really don't like that. They really love it when brothers and sisters get along together. And so Jesus wants us all to get along together, even after he's gone. And when he's gone from walking around on the earth, part of what this tells us is that he will still be with us, that he will be with God, and God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit will be a living presence in our lives for those who believe. So I'm going to read this passage of scripture now as a prayer. And this is from the Message Bible. So you can pray this with me. Jesus said these things: Father, it's time. Display the bright splendor of your Son, so the Son in turn may show your bright splendor. You put him in charge of everything human, so he might give real and eternal life to all in his charge. And this is the real and eternal life, that they know you, the one and only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you sent. I glorified you on earth by completing down to the last detail what you assigned me to do. And now, Father, glorify me with your very own splendor, the very splendor I had in your presence before there was even a world. I spelled out your character in detail to the men and women you gave me. They were yours in the first place. Then you gave them to me. And they have now done what you said. They know now beyond the shadow of a doubt that everything you gave me is firsthand from you. For the message you gave me, I gave them. They took it and were convinced that I came from you. They believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I'm not praying for the God-rejecting world, but for those you gave me, for they are yours by right. Everything mine is yours, and yours mine, and my life is on display in them, for I am no longer going to be visible in the world. They'll continue in the world while I return to you. Holy Father, guard them as they pursue this life that you conferred as a gift through me, so they can be one heart and mind, as we are one heart and mind. And this is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. And now let's join our hearts together in singing.
The atmosphere is changing now.
Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all
bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.